Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll discuss polynomial identities and find the squares of sum and difference using them. And here we will prove following identities. First identity is x plus y whole square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. And second identity is x minus y whole square is equal to x square minus 2xy plus y square. Then third identity is x square minus y square is equal to x plus y the whole into x minus y the whole. And the fourth identity is x square plus y square whole square is equal to x square minus y square whole square plus 2xy whole square. And in this session, we will discuss these polynomial identities. Now let us discuss squares of sum and difference. Now in our earlier session, we have learned how to multiply two polynomials. And here we see that product of some pairs of binomials, that is polynomials having two terms, follow a specific pattern. One such pattern is square of the sum, that is x plus y whole square, which can be written as x plus y the whole into x plus y the whole. Now we can see the pattern from the following diagram. Here we have taken a square, that is this bigger square whose side is of length x plus y. Now let us name it as A, B, C, D. So area of square ABCD is equal to side square, which is equal to x plus y whole square. Now in the diagram we can see that area of square ABCD is composed of a square of side x, that is this blue portion, then two rectangles of sides x and y, that is this pink portion and white portion, and a square of side y, that is this yellow portion. So area of the square with side x is x square, then area of this rectangle with sides x and y is xy. Similarly, area of this rectangle is again xy, and area of the square with side y is y square. Now if we add areas of all these figures in square ABCD, then we will get area of the square ABCD. So on adding the areas of all these figures, this will be equal to x square plus xy plus xy plus y square, which is equal to x square plus xy plus xy will be 2xy plus y square. So area of the square ABCD, that is x plus y whole square, is equal to sum of the areas of all these figures in the square ABCD, which is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. So x plus y whole square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. Now let us solve it algebraically. Let us open the product by multiplying the two binomials. Here, multiplying each term of first polynomial with second polynomial, we have x into x plus y the whole plus y into x plus y the whole, and this is equal to x square plus xy plus yx plus y square, which is equal to x square plus xy plus, now multiplication is commutative, so yx can be written as xy plus y square. Now adding the like terms, we have x square plus xy plus xy will be 2xy, so this will be x square plus 2xy plus y square. Thus, square of the sum, that is equal to x plus y whole square, is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. Now, if we replace y by minus y in this above identity of square of sum, then we get x plus of minus y whole square is equal to x square plus 2 into x into minus y plus of minus y whole square, which implies x plus of minus y will be x minus y whole square is equal to x square minus 2xy plus, now minus y whole square will be y square. And this gives us identity of square of difference. Now let us discuss an example. And here we have to find 3a square plus 5b whole square. Now it is square of sum of two terms. So here I will use this identity, that is x plus y whole square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. Now here, let us take the first term, that is 3a square, as x, and the second term, that is 5b, as y. Now we will apply this identity. So 3a square plus 5b whole square will be equal to x square, that is 3a square whole square, plus 2 into x, that is 3a square, into y, that is 5b, plus y square, that is 5b whole square. Now 3a square whole square will be equal to 9 into a raised to power 2 into 2, that is a raised to power 4. So the first term is 9 into a raised to power 4 plus, now 2 into 3 into 5 is 30, and a square into b will be a square b plus, now 5b whole square will be 25b square. And this is the required answer. And now let us discuss difference of squares of two terms. Now let us consider two terms, x and y. Now their sum will be equal to x plus y, and difference will be x minus y. Now the product of sum and difference of these two terms will be equal to x plus y the whole into x minus y the whole. So here we have x plus y the whole into x minus y the whole. Now here we can use a diagram to find the pattern. Now here let us consider a square of side x. Let the square be P, Q, R, S. So area of the square PQRS is equal to side square, that is x square. Now from this square we have to cut another square of side y. Our area of this square, that is this smaller square, is equal to side square, that is y square. Now to find the leftover area, we subtract the area of cut square from the given square of side x. So area of the remaining portion will be equal to area of the square with side x minus area of the square with side y. So area of the remaining portion will be x square minus y square. Now here you can see that this remaining area has two rectangles. The first rectangle with sides x and x minus y, and the second rectangle with sides x minus y and y. So area of this bigger rectangle will be x into x minus y the whole, and area of this smaller rectangle will be y into x minus y the whole. So the required leftover area, that is area of the remaining portion, will be equal to sum of the areas of these two rectangles, that is equal to x into x minus y the whole plus y into x minus y the whole, which is equal to, now here you can see x minus y the whole is a common factor, so taking it common we have x minus y the whole into x plus y the whole. So the remaining area, that is x square minus y square, is equal to x minus y the whole into x plus y the whole. And this is the required identity. Now let us solve it algebraically. Now here we will multiply each term of the first polynomial with the second polynomial. So this will be equal to x into x minus y the whole plus y into x minus y the whole, which is equal to, now x into x is x square, then x into minus y is minus xy, plus y into x is yx, and as product is commutative, so yx can be written as xy, then y of minus y is minus y square. Now combining the like terms, these terms will be cancelled with each other, and this is equal to x square minus y square. Thus we have x square minus y square is equal to x plus y the whole into x minus y the whole. Now let us discuss an example. Here we have to solve 3a minus 11 the whole into 3a plus 11 the whole. Now it is the product of sum and difference of two same terms. So here we will apply this identity. Now here let us take 3a as x and 11 as y, and here we have to find x minus y the whole into x plus y the whole. So applying this identity, this will be equal to x square, that is 3a whole square, minus y squared, that is 11 whole square. And this is equal to, now 3a whole square is equal to 9a square minus 11 square is 121. And this is the required answer. Now let us discuss its application. Now we can use these identities in factorization. Now suppose we have a polynomial x square minus 81 and we have to factorize it. So we can write it as x square minus 9 square. Now using this identity, we have x square minus y square is equal to x minus y the whole into x plus y the whole. So this will be equal to x minus 9 the whole into x plus 9 the whole. So here we have factorized the given polynomial. Now let us derive this result. Now here let us start with the left hand side, that is x square plus y square whole square. For this we will use this identity, that is the identity of square of sum. So this will be equal to x square whole square plus 2 into x square into y square plus y square whole square. Now this is equal to, now x square whole square is equal to x raised to power 2 into 2, that is x raised to power 4, plus 2x square y square plus, now y square whole square is y raised to power 4. And now let us start with the right hand side. Now here for opening the brackets, that is for solving x square minus y square whole square, we will use this identity, that is the identity of square of difference. Now using this identity, x square minus y square whole square will be x square whole square minus 2 x square y square plus y square whole square plus, now 2xy whole square is equal to 4 x square y square. Now this is equal to x raised to power 4. Now combining the like terms, minus 2x square y square plus 4x square y square will be plus 2x square y square plus y square whole square is y raised to power 4. Thus left hand side is equal to right hand side. So we have x square plus y square whole square is equal to x square minus y square whole square plus 2xy whole square. Similarly, we can write x minus y whole square is equal to x plus y whole square minus 4xy. Now replacing y by minus y in this identity, we have x minus of minus y whole square is equal to x plus of minus y whole square minus 4 into x into minus y. And this implies x plus y whole square is equal to x minus y whole square plus 4xy. So in this session we have discussed polynomial identities. And this completes the session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.